Grab your hard hat, because in the next 30 minutes we'll take an in-depth look at how frac sand mining and processing works in Wisconsin with a visit to Superior Silica Sands. You'll see the entire process, from excavators and mine trucks to front-end loaders feeding the impactor, and the journey through the washing process at the wet plant. Watch as clean sand passes through the dewatering screens and is stockpiled. Follow along as we take a short trip to the state-of-the-art dry plant in New Auburn, Wisconsin. See the large bag house, the dryer, the screen deck with Rotex machines, the control room. Finally, you'll see the rail loadout, filling the rail cars with various finished product sizes, and shipment by train to various destinations throughout the United States and Canada. Located in Chippewa County, this is Superior Silica Sands Auburn Mine, which was established in 2010. Chippewa County's rolling landscape has an ocean-like quality of wave after wave of sandy soil hilltops. The geological history of this countryside goes back 500 million years. At that time, much of the North American continent was covered with a shallow ocean. For a long period of time, a shoreline covered parts of Minnesota and here in Wisconsin. The constant wave action of this inland sea laid down layers of coarse sand consisting of mostly quartz. Centuries of wave action then made the sand grains rounder and rounder. Today, the Chippewa Valley sand deposits are called Northern White Sand, and is the world's finest when it comes to frac sand. These ancient layers of loosely cemented sandstone are clearly seen here in the Superior Silica Sands Auburn Mine. Before sand mining can begin, all Wisconsin regulations and permits must be filled out and approved. Sand mining is done in sections, with phase one being the removal of top and subsoils that are known as overburden. Phase two consists of blasting and mining of the usable sandstone, and phase three is reclaiming each section of land after it's been mined by returning sub and top soils to a usable and productive rolling landscape. What makes the Chippewa Valley frac sand deposit so desirable is that it lies close to the surface of the ground, making it easier to mine. In the background, we get a good look at the layers of overburden that are being removed from the hillsides and trucked to the reclamation stockpiles. The ground layers consist of top and subsoils being silt, loam, and clay, then a layer of unusable sandstone before reaching the frac sand quality sandstone that'll be mined, washed, and stockpiled here at the Auburn Mine. Reclamation purposes, the mine has separate stockpiles for topsoil, subsoil, and fines, which is the reject sand from the wash plant that's too small for hydrofracking. When a section of the pit is mined out, the reclamation process begins by replacing the appropriate layers of sub and topsoil and then seeding. The reclamation area will then generally match the grade of the surrounding landscape and then be turned back over to the landowner for use as farmland or other general purposes. Wisconsin open pit frac sand mines are usually not very deep and only remove sand from above the groundwater table. A drilling crew is preparing the next section of land for blasting. A vertical drill is used to create a series of holes in a grid pattern. Some of the holes in this hillside are marked with green pails. Explosives are then lowered into the holes, and since the sandstone is loosely cemented, the mine blast is only strong enough to pop the sand, so it's loosened up and ready to be scooped up with the excavator. Superior Silica Sands excavator down in the pit is a Cat 374B that has a 10-yard bucket. The mine haul trucks will be loaded with 30 to 35 tons of sand that will be hauled up the hill to the impactor. The approaching mine truck is a Caterpillar 740B articulated truck that's powered by a 489-horsepower Cat C15 diesel engine that's Tier 4 emissions compliant. The mine haul truck has auto shift 7-speed forward and 2-speed reverse transmission and the big mine truck also comes loaded with operational and personal safety features. The loosely bound sandstone at this stage of mining is now broken down into individual sand grains or small chunks that can be easily scooped up and loaded into the mine trucks. The sand is also an orangey-brown color at this point, as it contains clay and shale that needs to be removed and washed away at the wet plant. That 740V articulated mine haul truck measures approximately 36 feet long, 12 feet 4 inches wide, and 13 feet 3 inches high. The truck has a payload capacity of 43.5 tons. The short mine haul brings the sand up the hill and out of the pit to this dumping area. A front-end loader will then take over and scoop up the sand, which is fed into the hopper of the impactor, which will be the next process in the making of frac sand. Auburn Mine and wet plant are usually operated from April through November and then are shut down for the winter months. The only portion of the mine that remains operating year-round are the dump trucks that transport wash sand from the stockpiles to the dry plant, which we'll see later in the mining process. Front-end loader is now dumping the sand into the hopper of the impactor, which will lightly break up any sandstone chunks without fracturing the individual sand grains, which is a very important feature of frac sand. Sand is then sent by a conveyor to an area where rocks and oversized pieces are screened out and sent on a second conveyor to the reject pile. This material is then sent back into the mine pit and stockpiled for use in the reclamation process. The good sand that makes it through the screens at the impactor are then fed down into the red hopper, where water is added to the sand to create a slurry that is then pumped under pressure to the wet plant for washing. Superior Silica Sands Auburn Mine covers 450 acres and has an expected lifespan of 20 years. From the impactor, the sand slurry is pumped through a 20-inch pipe to the top of the wet plant, where the sand goes through a sizing and washing process. The sand slurry is fed here into the hydrolyzer, which spins like a cyclone to size and separate the sand grains. The heavier sand grains go down to the next level in the washing process, and the ultra-fine unusable sand, that being greater than 100 mesh, becomes reject sand. Next, the good sand slurry is sent down the plant to the scrubber, which functions a little like an industrial clothes washer for sand. The scrubber's rotating paddles wash and remove dirt, clay, shale, and silt from the sand. The muddy, dirty water then flows over the edge and down to the settling tank. The clay, dirt, and unusable sand go to the bottom of the settling tank, which is seen to the left, and then is pumped out to the right, going to the belt press, which squeezes out the water to create a solid reject material that's known as fines. The fines are then sent out by a conveyor to the reject pile for reclamation. Most of the water that's used in the wet plant is recovered and then recycled back into the system. On the next level down, the frac sand gets a clean water rinse before it goes to the dewatering screens. Clean frac sand is now being discharged by the dewatering screen for a trip onto the conveyor belt to the finished stockpile. Superior Silica Sands wet plant can operate at a maximum speed of 500 tons per hour, but the average production rate is usually more around the range of 300 tons per hour. Clean frac sand now has a light sandy color to it, as it's seen here being sent by conveyor belt to the stockpile. The sand is still fairly damp at this stage and usually sits and drains for a few weeks before being sent by truck to the processing plant for drying and screening of the product sizes. Superior Silica Sands Auburn Mine and wet plant employ approximately 22 workers. Front-end loader is now used to fill the dump trucks with fresh, clean frac sand. These trucks will usually be loaded with around 22 to 23 tons of sand. Superior Silica Sands contracts the sand transportation from the mine to the dry plant to a private trucking company. This is the CT Trucking Company that operates a fleet of 18 trucks and employs approximately 25 drivers. A tarp is used to cover the sand load for the trip to the New Auburn dry plant. Before departing the mine and wet plant, the truck sand loads are weighed and recorded. Superior Silica Sands is a leading producer of high-quality frac sand for the oil and natural gas industry. In Wisconsin in 2013, they operated several mines and two production facilities, with one here in New Auburn and a second in Clinton in nearby Barron County. Being centrally located in the U.S., Superior Silica Sands can efficiently and economically ship frac sand by rail or truck to most parts of North America. The dry plant here has five silos for holding the finished frac sand products, including four 1,000-ton capacity silos and one 400-ton capacity. Throughout the day, a steady stream of trucks arrive at the dry plant with frac sand from the mine. The New Auburn plant has two loadout towers for their finished sand products. One is for loading rail cars, and the second one that we see here is for trucks. This truck is being loaded with frac sand that will be sent to a plant in Illinois, where the sand will be resin coated to make it an even stronger and rounder proppant in the hydrofracking process. A sand truck has just completed its 24-mile round trip to the mine as the driver arrives back at the dry plant. The driver pulls into the sand barn where the truck's load will be dumped. This indoor facility can hold up to 15,000 tons of sand, but that rarely happens as the plant's front-end loader is constantly scooping up buckets of sand to feed the hopper. Working in the barn today is Mike King with a 267 horsepower Cat 966K. The front end loader has a bucket capacity of 7 yards for building up the stockpiles and carrying sand to feed the dry plant's hopper. At this point, the frac sand is still damp as it comes over from the mine and wet plant and must now be conveyed through the dryer before the sand can be separated by grain size, which in the sand industry is referred to as mesh size. The conveyor from the feed hopper has a screen over it to catch any pebbles that might have gotten into the sand along its journey to the dry plant. The next step of the operation is the dryer, which will remove all moisture content from the sand. The huge dryer is fueled by natural gas and has a processing rate of 200 tons per hour. The dryer operates at a temperature of up to 850 degrees. Anything higher and it'll automatically shut down. All sand conveyors in the plant are enclosed and operate with a vacuum system to keep any dust out of the air. This side of the dry plant contains the huge baghouse, which has 784 filter bags to trap any dusty air coming off the dryer. On the top, it goes into the clean air vent and eventually circulates out the exit stack. Plus, the hot air is caught and circulated back into the dryer so it runs more efficiently and uses less gas. The plant's dryer is mounted on a spring and set at an angle. Underneath the unit is a drive arm that's styled like a crankshaft to create a wobbling motion. As the sand passes through the dryer, hot air is forced up from underneath to create a bubbling or puffing of the sand. And when it reaches the end of the unit, the sand is dried to zero humidity. After drying the sand, it's fed into a bucket elevator for a lift upstairs to the next level, and then dumped into the feed hopper for the Rotec sand screeners. On the screen deck, the new Auburn plant has six large Rotec sand screening machines. The Rotec screens and separates the sand grains by size. It's just a matter of shaking the screens to get the small sand particles to fall through one level after another and sorted into the proper sand tubes. Plant workers are checking the sand screens as it's critical that all these screens are functioning properly. From the screening deck, the various sand grains go down the proper tubes and then are conveyor belted to the corresponding storage silos. Superior Silica Sands' new Auburn dry plant processes and ships five different sizes of frac sand that are called mesh sizes. They range in sizes from 1630 being the largest grain to 100 mesh being the smallest sand grain. Typically 1630, 2040, and 3050 are used for drilling oil wells. The 4070 and 100 mesh are used on natural gas wells. The Superior Silica Sands control room is where the new Auburn processing plant operations are monitored by computer and video surveillance. The lead man running the control room today is Jim Turner, and explaining its operation is Dwayne Wilkie.
Jim's got it set to 198 ton an hour. Shows percent coming up on the screen. There's that screen we're out that takes care of the oversize. Got a belt scale that says how many ton per hour is coming up into the dryer. Jimbo here has burnt 727 tons so far in his shift today. He comes in, it shows the sand should be like a curve and then down. 144, 48, 236, 239, 17, she curves down. It shows here in the hop, going up the bucket elevator. Here it shows how much is in the hopper. Here's our bag house. Shows the temperature here at 155, that's to get it above the dew point so it stays dry in there. So the bags perform properly, and this is our differential pressure from our hot and our cold size. And it tells me if there's a bag bad or not bad. But on this screen here, it just shows how much is in each silo, what the silo levels are. It shows all of our conveyors running that are going to the silos. This shows our screen decks. All screens are running. Hopper here. This is our dust collection bag house, shows all that. Here it shows the rail loadout. They're taking out of silo 3, so they're taking 3050 right now. And they called for 50 ton, and it shows them loading it on the belt. Like on 4070, we're doing 33 ton an hour roughly right now. 100 mesh is 12 ton an hour. 3050, we're making 83 ton an hour. 2040, 35, 1630, we're making 9 to 10 tons an hour. And we can make more of 2040, a little less of 3050, and we can change screens around to make them more 4070. So whatever we have from orders from the customers, we can adjust our screens so that we make the required amount of product for each order for the week. The truck's dumping. He can see how full his hopper is. He can pan it, he can move it to where he wants. Here's truck loadout. When a truck pulls in, he can actually see the truck pull in. He can tell him where to stop. Shows a night, well, it's somewhat of a picture. So anything we do, he can look at that screen that we're looking for the oversize. He can watch that and make sure that's operating. Out here, he can look at the reject sand on the reject pile. We try to keep it as close to the conveyor so we keep the amount of how far it falls down. That way you don't get any dust. So the closer you keep it to the transfer point, the better off we are. And then here's just a camera. When, especially at night when they're working, they can watch oncoming traffic or somebody comes in the plant they don't know. They'll see them coming down the road.
Next to employee safety, quality control of Superior Silica Sands product lines is of top priority. The various mesh sizes are tested between every 30 to 60 minutes to make sure the sand has been properly washed and sized to meet frac sand industry specifications. Next, the Rotap is used to test and see if the sand products meet specs, making sure each finished mesh size is neither too coarse or too fine. Now we go back to the dry plant. After the frac sand is screened to its finished product sizes, it goes down these tubes and onto conveyor belts, which send the products to its proper storage silo. Plus reject sand that is either too large or too small of grain is sent to the reject stockpile and trucked back to the mine. The New Auburn plant's 5 storage silos holds the finished products and has a conveyor system that feeds the truck and rail car loader. Superior Silica Sands leases the switch locomotives from Progressive Rail, but provides their own train crews to do the plant switching and to work the rail car loader. The plant switcher, CIT number 1559, is a 1,500 horsepower SW1500 that was originally built by EMD in 1968 for the Southern Pacific Railroad and later saw service on the Norfolk Southern. Safely secured on top of the hopper car, plant worker Dave LaRue is opening the hatch covers as he prepares the cars for loading. The train crew will pull blocks of cars out of the rail yard for the various frac sand customers. The office will then have car numbers and what sand product goes in each car. Hopper cars are then loaded with the use of a computer by the person who is working the loadout tower. From a PO, the worker enters the car number, product, and total weight of the frac sand to be loaded, and then the information gets recorded. The truck and rail loaders have a New Zealand dust control system that removes dust in the air while loading. The loader also has a telescoping tube that the workers refer to as the elephant trunk. Each two-bay covered hopper car holds approximately 110 tons of frac sand, and the train crews load in the range of 30 to 50 cars in a day. The New Auburn Dry Plant loads hopper cars 7 days per week. Today's northbound Wisconsin Northern train is approaching the plant and rail yard. This is Wisconsin Northern Job L1, the daytime local. The train contains a long cut of hopper cars for the sand plant that they'll be dropping off at the north end of the yard. Superior Silica Sands' large and growing rail yard contains 6 yard tracks and 2 holding tracks, with a total rail car capacity of 425 cars. The street sweeper is used around the plant each day to keep on top of any stray sand. The plant's second locomotive, number 2630, is also an SW1500 that was originally built in 1972 for the Southern Pacific. Superior Silica Sands, 2 Wisconsin sand plants also have truck-to-train transfer loadouts. This is used when a large order comes in and additional sand is needed from the other plant to help quickly fill the order, or if the frac sand needs to be transferred to get a better rail shipping rate to certain North American destinations. The New Auburn plant is situated on the Wisconsin Northern Railroad and then sent across the Union Pacific rail system. The Clinton plant near Barron originates on the Canadian National rail system, the locations in U.S. and Canada. The air quality here is monitored inside as well as outside and near the plant. The New Auburn air quality is continually found to be very safe according to U.S. EPA standards. In fact, in 2014, the DNR's findings showed that Wisconsin silica sand plants are not contributing to air pollution. A Wisconsin Northern Southbound departs Superior Silica Sands with Union Pacific diesel power on a unit train of gondolas that are loaded with frac sand. In the early days of operation, the New Auburn plant ran a few unit trains of frac sand with the use of these open-top gondolas. Each car contained 114 tons of wash sand from the mine, but it was not yet processed or sized to a finished product. This would be done later at a plant in Texas. To get your copy of this exciting 105-minute narrated video, which is available in DVD, Blu-ray, or streaming on Vimeo, just click on the link below or visit our website at www.pletzexpress.com. Please subscribe to our channel and thank you for watching.